homeowners, just kill them.
Now, one lawmaker says that's not going far enough and wants to do even more to get rid of our iguana invasion.
ABC 7's Simone Cucurulo went out to Cape Coral today and is getting us more on the scale of the problem on this latest proposal.
Here at Pet Kingdom, certain iguanas like Spike here are going to be exempt from the new bill. That's because Spike is a rhino iguana. They're actually non-invasive to the state of Florida, unlike the two species that this bill would impact. Those are the green iguanas and black and white tegus.
I got a couple jobs.
But for Teddy Tursky,
I stay pretty busy.
His position as a reptile and fish specialist at Pet Kingdom isn't work at all.
This is not even really a job. This is more just for, like, fun. That's what I say.
In addition to cleaning tanks and taking care of the fish and reptiles, this animal lover's goal is to educate the public before buying certain kinds of pets.
Unfortunately, when people do release these species, they can have an impact out in the environment.
That's part of the reason why Teddy's employer, Pet Kingdom, has stopped selling species of large iguanas to prepare for the bill currently moving through the Senate that aims to ban the sale of green iguanas and black and white tegus.
I know there's problems for sure.
So how big of a problem is it?
There's so many. We have so many on our dock.
Just ask Cape Coral couple Keith and Maria Scott.
There's a lot of broken seawalls from it, and they dig into everything and they make a mess.
They live by Southeast 12th Terrace in the Cape, not far from where this photo was snapped over the weekend. Nearby restaurant First Round Draft even told us it's a big issue for them as well.
It is an unfortunate reality that we have to face here in the reptile and fish pet kingdom world.
But for Teddy, the opportunity to teach people about Florida's iguana invasion.
We want to slow that down and stop it as much as possible.
Is all part of the job.
Lawmakers had the day off today for the Martin Luther King Jr. holiday, but they'll be back in session later this week. For now, I'm reporting in Cape Coral tonight with Spike the Rhino Iguana, Simone Cucurulo, ABC 7.